I wish you'd smile more when you're gardening, Richard.
If I do that, they're going to lock me away.
Try to look as though you're enjoying it, dear.
But I don't particularly enjoy it. It's just something that has to be done.
Well, that's how it appears.
The garden looks well enough.
Oh, it's not the garden, dear. It's you. You look as though you're not enjoying doing it, which gives the impression that we can't afford a gardener.
Can't afford a gardener?
Shh, Richard, keep your voice down, dear. If we can't afford a gardener, that's all the more reason why we should look as though we can afford a gardener. So in future, could you look like someone who enjoys doing his own gardening, but could afford a gardener if he wanted to? Oh, I do believe that's the Carradines. It was the Carradines. She used to be Baxter's Biscuits, you remember?
I remember.
Oh. Oh. Unmannerly oaf. Sheridan would be furious if he knew that strangers were honking at his mummy.
Do you think there's life after death? I hope so. There's not that much before.
I'm just getting my second wind.
And all this loving your neighbours stuff. I mean, just look at the sort of neighbours we've got. I mean, anybody who lives next door to us is hardly the kind of neighbour that you can go about loving. Mind if I lived with our Hyacinth. Her neighbour's terrific. Emmett. Does she?
If anybody's loved their neighbours, you have. I bet nobody's cast a wider net.
What's brought all this on our Rose? I met this born-again Christian.
Where?
In the pub.
Must have been his night off.
What are you doing?
I'm just emptying the pedal bin, dear.
I've done that.
Oh, yes, so you have, silly me. Anyway, I'm just coming.
What are you doing now? What are you doing?
When you're retired, you have to be particularly careful about being in drafts. I'm just checking the letterbox to make sure we haven't received any more leaflets about cheap double glazing.
Thank you.
birthday tomorrow. Are you looking forward to your present? Are you excited, dear? You don't look it. I will not have you not excited, Richard.
Well, I usually get slippers. I mean, nobody likes slippers more than I do, but they're not an item about which you get really excited. So if you don't mind, I'll wait until tomorrow to get excited.
As you please. Oh, it's very late. Is that an emergency? The bouquet residence, the lady of the house speaking. Look, if this is an emergency, please say it's not Sheridan. Oh, it's you, Rose, yes. Do I believe in what, dear? Well, of course I believe there's life after death. Richard and I will be an entity for eternity. Where are you on life after death?
I'm an optimistic, don't know.
If there is an afterlife, do you think we'll be slimmer?
I expect so. I don't suppose they'll do as many chips.
Maybe they'll let us send out for some chips.
I just fancy some chips.
Hyacinth doesn't think it's a good idea that I talk to the vicar.
I bet the vicar's wife doesn't think it's a good idea either.
You only want to talk to him because he's a dishy vicar. Listen, if I'm going to go religious, I might as well go first class.
Here, Rose, are you feeling Christian enough to do us all a few chips?
Bog off, Onslow.
Oh, nice.
Born again, bone idol. Now, Richard, just stand there, dear, and keep your eyes tightly closed.
We don't usually have all this fuss. Normally, you just give me the slippers.
Now, you keep them closed. I'll be with you in a minute. Keep them closed. You can open them now. Happy birthday, Richard.
What is it? It's a drain pipe. You bought me a drain pipe.
Well, go on, open it. Open it. Oh, come on. We ought to wish Richard a happy birthday.
I do wish Richard a happy birthday, Liz. If anyone ever needed a happy birthday, it is Richard.
Well, then, come on. Emmett, you can't stay hiding indoors forever. Do you know you're getting prison pallor?
I'll catch him when he's alone.
When is Richard ever alone?
Precisely, Liz. Maybe I could sneak him off for a quiet drink somewhere. Give the poor devil a break.
I'm sure he'd enjoy that.
The trick is trying to get him free from the clutches of the creature from the Black Lagoon. Frankenstein created a monster. And it sings.
Look, take the bull by the horns. Just say to Hyacinth, I'm going to take Richard out for a birthday drink.
You want me to take her by the horns? What kind of advice is that?
Skis?
All the best people have them.
What am I going to do with skis?
Well, I thought they'd look well on the car, dear. You can take them for a drive occasionally.
The Caradines, they have skis on their car.
What a coincidence.
The wrong age for skis.
Nonsense. You're never too old to put skis on your car.
Seems a bit odd buying skis not to ski.
Oh, Richard. You don't imagine everyone who has skis on his car actually skis. Good heavens, no. Expect everyone with a feather in his hat to be a partridge.
Well, how am I going to get them on the car? It means I'll have to buy one of those rack things.
No. You can put in violets and bruises. They used to ski.
Then why didn't you borrow Violet and Bruce's skis?
Richard, I will not have you going about with shabby, substandard, borrowed skis. No, you can take your new skis to Violet's, and then we'll borrow their rack.
Oh, I can leave the skis here and just go and get the rack.
But then the people in Bruce's area won't see you with your new skis. Only a second-hand rack. To me, Richard. Oh, that'll be someone important. The bouquet residence, the lady of the house speaking. Oh, hello, Rose. Yes. Well, why do you want the vicar's telephone number, dear? What sort of questions? Oh, I don't think you can ask the vicar a question like that, Rose. Well, yes, I'm sure that he'd see you privately if you insist. You'd have to go to the vicarage. What makes you think the vicarage will be unfriendly, dear? Well, yes, of course, I suppose his wife will be there. What sort of a personal chat is it you want with this vicar? Look, Rose, if you need somewhere private, bring him here. Then I can keep an eye on you and Richard can show him his skis.
Happy birthday, Richard.
Thank you, Emmett.
Are you going skiing?
I'm going to her sister Violet's, actually.
Didn't know they lived that far north.
Hello, Emmett. How are you?
I was feeling quite well, thank you, Hyacinth.
We're just off to my sister Violet's. You know, the one with the Mercedes, the sauna, and room for a pony. Richard, please be more careful.
I think that's the highest note you've reached in quite a while.
Mind what you're doing with those skis.
There's more ski than car.
Oh, they'll be fine once we've borrowed Bruce's rack. What do you wear for a vicar? Whatever it is, you won't have that kind of stuff. How about a dishy vicar? Behave yourself, Rose. You're supposed to be interested in life after death, not before.
Did you shuffle these cards?
I'm a good shuffler.
That's in bed.
How would you know? You're never awake. That's what I miss. A little companionship in my lonely bed.
No wonder yours is a lonely bed. You're always in somebody else's.
Well, it's just a desperate search for happiness.
Why'd you give me cards like this?
It's such a relief to see you getting worked up about something.
Just play the cards.
Oh, I love it when he orders me to do things. Yeah!
Be able to drive.
Oh, do stop making difficulties, Richard.
Me make difficulties.
You're never going to get the hang of skis if you don't practice with them. Oh, Richard, just skiing on my hat.
It's difficult enough making room for your hats. Never mind skis.
I want you to start being at ease with skis, Richard.
I wish you bought me slippers. I'm at ease with slippers.
I really thought you'd take to all this much quicker, Richard. You're quite good with snowballs and Christmassy things.
There's more to this than just enjoying a mince pie.
When we get to Violet's, don't park the car next to the Mercedes, Richard. I always think our car looks better not parked next to a Mercedes. Oh, look! Isn't that the two Miss Pillsworths? Yes, it is! Stop the car, Richard! We'll give them a lift.
Suppose they don't want a lift.
You remember their father.
There's not room for him as well.
No, their father was Colonel Pillsworth, a very old family. Them to come to one of my candlelight suppers. But apparently the elder Miss Pillsworth is allergic to naked flame.
Aren't we all?
I promised you'd extinguish her straight away. Oh, Lord, it's a candlelight queen. Fate must be drawing us together. Do let us give you a lift.
What does she say?
She wants to give us a lift.
Are you sure there'll be room?
You must make room, Richard.
Why should we give her a lift?
Pay attention. I will not stand to attention.
Who does she think she is?
Come along, lady.
it is. Oh, excuse me. Would you like to come round the other side? I think you know Richard.
How are you, Richard? How long have you driven for this woman? Don't know how you can stand it.
Are you expecting snow?
Richard seldom goes far without his skis. He likes to be ready for the first flakes.
I'm just a beginner.
Don't get any thinner.
There we are.
The strain is too much for my suspender.
Some other time, Mrs. Bucket.
It's okay.
It's not okay by me.
Crescent, I don't think this is going to work.
Where there's a will, Richard.
Excuse me.
Recipe and a jar of my delicious gentleman's relish. I have an extensive repertoire of tidbits for the executive palate.
Like a rhinestone cowboy making out on a horse at the Star-Spangled Rodeo. Like a rhinestone cowboy.
You're in a good mood? Why not? Thank you. It's been almost like a holiday. A little holiday. An entire week without a bucket.
A bucket?
The dreaded bucket.
Oh, that one.
Yes, oh, that one. It's too good to last, of course, but it's been refreshing. Which is more than I can say for this tea.
I know, isn't it awful?
Well, why do we buy it?
We don't. The ladies' circle gets it for us at a discount.
Oh, isn't that marvellous? To realise that in the eyes of my flock, I'm associated with the utmost in economy. I think they only keep a vicar because we're cheaper than most domestic animals.
They like you.
Not judging by this tea, they don't.
To my sister Violet's.
Violet's? I suspected as much.
And then we'll take you to where you were going.
Oh, we would have been there by now.
You like my sister Violet, and he's very well known in racing circles. Violet once had tea with the wife of the Postmaster General. She still has the plastic spoon.
You silly!
Reverse, Richard. Now, Richard.
Wasn't that your Violet pouring?
Take the tourists, Pillsworths, and show them the beauties of the area. It's a very, very nice residential area. Enjoy the trip, Miss Pillsworth,
And do take note of the gay colours of the more upmarket security systems.
That person was pouring water.
Yes, and did you notice the lovely glass? My sister has the most superior glassware. This one. Some of it most tastefully engraved with a list of injured jockeys. Off you go, Richard. Now. And leave them at a bus stop, dear.
We being kidnapped? Will she want a ransom? Can we afford a ransom?
Why can't she walk to the vicarage?
Oh, for goodness sake, you can give the woman a lift. We were going that way anyway.
Who was?
I was. To the library.
I'm just a plaything in the hands of you females.
Can I have that in writing?
I'm not a toy, Daze. You've got to stop thinking of me as just a sexual object. I'm not just here for your amusement.
Oh, come on. You're here partially for my amusement. You can't find everything in the library.
We need a new car.
You should spend more time with me. My engine's still running.
What scheme things when my heart is broken? Take it!
Please don't exaggerate, Violet. Your heart is not broken. Are seldom broken in good residential areas.
Lucy Skirak, thank you.
That's very kind of you, dear. We'll take good care of it.
How can you think of skiing when my life's in tatters?
Not tatters, Violet. Not in an area with a postal code of this caliber.
I'm leaving him. I'm leaving Bruce.
Get the rack on, Richard. You cannot idly abandon marriage, Violet. Some things go too deep to be destroyed, dear. We all need things to cling to.
I think he even prefers jockeys.
Don't do anything hastily in anger, dear. Think of the loneliness, Violet. You cannot walk out on anything as solid and sober and respectable as your own Mercedes. Please talk to someone, dear. I want to talk to a vicar. Well, I can arrange that, dear. Yes, I'm sure you can save your marriage, Violet. Perhaps if you dressed a little more like a jockey. Now, drive quickly, Richard. We must get Violet to the vicar before she does something uneconomic. Stop! What you've done.
You told me to stop.
I didn't tell you to throw your birthday present under a passenger.
Why did you say stop?
You've forgotten Violet.
She was in the back. I mean, she was in the back.
You gather up your skis, dear, and I'll go and locate Violet. You don't need those yet. Doing all this, and you're sitting there.
Listen, that's what marriage is about. Doing things together.
I think it should start a motor. That's always been my impression.
You've got to learn to do these things. What are you going to do when I'm not here?
The same as we've done when you've been here. Do it ourselves.
Look at me. I'm as helpless as a kitten.
I think you're about to have a visitor.
That's what I'm here for.
I'm glad you feel like that.
It's a nuisance, of course, but first things first. Must have one's priorities. Duty calls. You know, my job is not without its satisfactions. People come in dismay and despair, and sometimes you can help.
This one really needs help.
Well, I'll certainly do my best.
It's a bucket woman.
Turn out, go away. To China.
What part of China?
What the devil does it matter what part of China?
It'll matter to her. She'll only be impressed if it's a smart part. Oh, come on, Michael.
Okay, I'll come and see her.
There's a brave chap. Good luck.
I've changed my mind. I don't want to see the vicar. It won't.
Now, come along, Violet. Pull yourself together.
I don't want to look like a jockey for him. The next thing you know, he'll have me jumping over fences. I want to divorce him.
You are not going to divorce him.
Oh, look! There's a squirrel. But...
Good morning.
Oh, hello, Vicar.
I don't think you've met my sister, Violet. She's the one with the Mercedes, sauna, and room for a pony.
Sometimes wonder at the activities of the posher classes.
Relentless. She's still chasing people to offer them lifts. Richard, follow that sister.